This video is brought to you by MyWayTeaching.com.
In this part, let us solve one important practical application. In a human pyramid in a circus, the entire weight of the balanced group is supported by the legs of a performer who is lying on his back. The combined mass of all the persons performing the act and the tables, plates, etc. involved is 280 kg. The mass of the performer lying on his back at the bottom of the pyramid is 60 kg, and each thin bone of this performer has a length of 50 cm and an effective radius of 2 cm. Determine the amount by which each thin bone gets compressed under the extra load. See, this is the example what they have taken. The person is lying here. It is supported with his back. The entire weight of this balanced group is supported by the legs of a performer who is lying on his back. The combined mass of all the persons who are performing this act, even the tables they have used in between, or including all these, it's 280 kg, the mass of the performer lying on his back at the bottom of the pyramid. Okay, this person's mass is 60 kg. And each thin bone or femur of this performer has a length of 50 cm and an effective radius of 2 cm. Now we should find the amount by which each thin bone gets compressed under the extra load. Okay. See, total mass of all the performers, tables, play cues, it is given by how much? Yes, it is 280 kg. And mass of the performer who is lying on his back. Is given by 60 kg, isn't it? And mass supported by the legs of the performer at the bottom of the pyramid. Okay, the mass which is supported only by the legs of the performer at the bottom of the pyramid. Is given by, here since it is supported by his legs, we should minus the mass of that person. Which is given by 280 minus 60, that is 220 kg. Okay, weight of this supported mass, okay, since this is in kg, we should convert it in terms of newton. So we know what to do. 220, that should be multiplied with 9.8. So we get 2156 newton. So weight supported by each thing bone of the performer is given by weight supported by each thing bone of the performer is given by 1/2 into 2156, which is given by 1078 newton. So the Young's modulus for the bone from the table that we studied is given by 9.4 into 10 raised to 9 newton per meter square. So here they have given length of each the thing bone 0.5 meter, and even they have given the radius, which is given by 2 centimeter, isn't it? Yes. And we can find the cross-sectional area pi r square, isn't it? Yes, if you simplify this, we get 1.26 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter square. This is the value of cross-sectional area. So now we got all the parameters. We can find the compression in each thing bone, which is nothing but delta L, which is equal to F cross L by Y cross A. So F is equal to 1078.5 meter is the length, and Young's modulus is 9.4 into 10 raised to 8. So it is 10 raised to 9. And area is given by 1.26 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is given by 4.55 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Okay, 4.55 10 raised to minus 3 centimeter. So this is very small change. The fractional decrease in the thing bone is very small. We can write it as 0.0091%. This is very, very small change in the length. Okay. So now let us learn determination of Young's modulus of the material of a wire. A typical experimental arrangement to determine the Young's modulus of the material of the wire under tension is given in this particular figure. See, this figure, it consists of two long straight wires of same length and equal radius suspended side by side from a fixed rigid support. isn't it? See, two wires. This is the reference wire and this is the experimental wire. It is suspended from the rigid support and these two wires are having same length and even equal radius. Okay. The wire A is called as reference wire. It carries a millimeter main scale M. This reference wire, it carries a millimeter, no, it carries a meter scale M. Okay. And the pan to place a weight. And the wire B, which is called as experimental wire of uniform area of cross section, it carries a pan in which known weights can be placed. This is the pan. See here. So here vernier scale V is attached to the pointer at the bottom of the experimental wire B. Isn't it? You can see that here. And the main scale is M, that is attached to the reference wire A. So the weights placed in the pan exert a downward force and stretch the experimental wire. The weights which is placed in this pan, it will exert a force and it will not only that, it will stretch the experimental wire under the tensile stress. So the elongation of the wire, which is nothing but increase in length, is measured by the vernier arrangement. Okay, so the reference wire is used to compensate for any change in length that may occur due to change in room temperature. Since any change in length of the reference wire due to temperature change will be accompanied, both reference and experimental wires are given an initial small load to keep the wires straight, and vernier reading is noted in that particular case. So now the experimental wire, it is gradually loaded with more weights in this way, you know, pan under a tensile stress, and the vernier reading is noted again. So the difference between the two vernier readings gives the elongation which is produced in the wire. So let R and L be the initial radius and length of the experimental wire. Okay. R and L be the initial radius and length of the experimental wire. Then the area of cross section is given by pi R square. And let M be the mass that produced an elongation delta L in the wire. So thus the applied force is equal to M into G. Isn't it? So where G is what? Yes, where G is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so the Young's modulus, we already know the equation for the Young's modulus, which is given by sigma by epsilon. So it is the ratio of tensile stress to the longitudinal strain. So here it is given by Mg by pi r square and L by delta L. Okay. We can write it as Mg cross L divided by pi r square into delta L. So this is the equation for Young's modulus of the material of the wire. So here this is tensile strength is given by, that is the applied force is mg and the area is pi r square, isn't it, divided by this longitudinal strain, that is delta L by L, isn't it? So if you again simplify or this, we'll get in the equation in this form, that is mg by pi r square into L by delta L. So that equation we can write it as mg cross L pi r square cross delta L. Okay.